these children would not be here without our support. Their mothers are whores and gin addicts. Their fathers are pimps and thieves. That's why we have started this orphanage, to help change their fortunes. As part of this musical evening, I, William Hogarth, am proud to exhibit the paintings that made my fortune. These paintings tell a story, the story of a harlot who could have been the mother of one of these boys. They describe a descent into a world of lechery and sin. Of vice and depravity. You may well be wondering how a respectable gentleman like me came to paint such scenes, how a man like me came to know a woman like this. Unhappily for me, hers was a world I knew only too well.
I was a lady's maid. I know how to do many things.
That's good. That's very good. I can do a lot with that.
Samuel, show us.
And what sent you running from York, Mary Collins?
I've heard London has much to recommend it.
Mr. Bentley. My lord.
Oh, Avery, another couple!
Your Grace. When did you last eat?
A few days ago. Alice.
What does your father do?
He's dead.
No, it'd be better if he were alive. You're too strict. Let's say he's a parson. Anglican. Nothing outlandish. Until now, your seething passions have never been satisfied. But they seethe.
Do you think you know how to seethe? Mother Needham, I know I may never be a wife. But I mean to find myself a rich gentleman all the same. He doesn't have to be handsome. Just rich.
Very good.
If you think I'm pretty or you wouldn't be giving me goose.
One thing at a time, eh? I'm sure we can find someone worthy of you. But you have to help me too. Show me how special you are. No.
A gift for you.
Hope you're not thinking of offering your parlour tricks as payment.
No, I'm not one of these men outbidding each other for your favours.
On the contrary. You are clearly an artist of world renown.
No, madam. The artist is my friend, William Hogarth. One day his name will be more renowned even than Mother Needham's.
Well, I hope that happy day is not too many decades in coming.
You go and tell Mr. Hogarth to practice his art on someone else.
Good mother.
She is mine. Wildly in this old fish.
Numbers here are still staggering. Thousands of children are in the worst stages of starvation.
Well, sir.
Not how far are they?
Well, sir.
Five children were being starved to death in these disgusting conditions.
Depression. Oh, new. Yes.
Whose is this child?
In this eastern pocket, a hellish pit of poverty, starvation still has its grip.
Come on! We've got time!
Mr. Hogarth?
Mr. Hogarth. Have you eaten?
Broth. It tasted of dog vomit.
Tomorrow eats at home.
Good idea.
Well, my bleeding is late.
Oh, that is good news.
Perhaps this time there is cause for excitement. Something's bothering you?
No. In fact, we both had a good day. I saw this girl straight off the London wagon and I felt compelled to draw her. I grabbed the nearest piece of paper and I drew her there and then. And then Fielding went up to her and... Well, you know Henry.
The next time you should take some paper.
Yes.
What is it?
A child. Another abandoned child. People stepping over him in the street. But of course, our child will never starve.
No. It'll be fine. And if we needed help, someone would help us.
She'll never borrow a penny from your father, Jane.
Of course not. Of course not. We won't need to. Have you left any wine for me?
Don't be shy.
Come on up here with me. As you're so special, I'll give you the room at the end. Robin, you'd be nice to this one. Her name's Mary. Just up here. Violet. She's an acquired taste. So's Larissa, in her condition. Here we are, then. Tomorrow I'll buy you a pretty silk gown and shoes with fine buckles. I think I'll take you to the milliner's on St. Martin's Lane.
Get that room ready, sir.
It's only fucking love. That's what you've got to remember.
But you're young, and you're beautiful, and you've got this look like purity. A girl like you, men will fall in love. I don't care if they fall in love.
Thank you.
fascinating, Will. So poignant. It seems to connect together.
Yes. Yes. They should be like pieces of theatre.
The young girl steps off the London wagon, straight into the arms of the ball. While all the other people just pretend not to notice. It's frightening. But this is such fine work too, Will. It's not entirely flattering, but it's very fine.
Don't worry, Janet. I shall finish the portrait.
Increasingly, women are being lured into prostitution here. They're promised good jobs and pay, but when they arrive, the gangs who brought them here sell them on.
Mr. Hogarth. It must be a popular trick drawing such likenesses so quickly.
I don't usually draw in public.
I didn't think artists painted ordinary people.
I only paint extraordinary people.
Flattery in drawing is no substitute for coin, Mr. Hogarth.
I shan't always be penniless.
Men always promise a dazzling future.
Her time costs money, sir.
When I'm a fine lady, with rank and distinction, maybe I'll pay for my own portrait. Or do you think it very foolish of me to imagine such a future?
No.
Yes, you do. But I shall make my fortune more swiftly than you. Miss Toga?
You haven't told me your name, madam.
An angel. Pure as starlight. Blood. Push it up your old hat, and when he bursts it, he'll think everything's where it ought to be. And remember about your father, the Anglican parson. And be sure to cry out, they like that.
I've heard fresh game can charge up to 100 guineas.
We might get 50 if we're lucky, and if you do your job well.
How much will I get?
Well, my poundage is 5 shillings in every guinea. You'll have to pay for the room, of course, and the clothes, and all that food you've been wolfing down. That goose wasn't cheap.
I could say 1,000 horse like you. Ordinarily, I would be interested. But today, I have my eye on a bigger prize.
She needs a few minutes.
Tell me she's perfect. Tell me she's exactly what I like.
The girl is very anxious to please you, sir. I think you'll find she's the best yet.
Sir.
Don't be afraid. I'll be gentle.
Oh. Don't be shy.
I'm sorry, sir. It's just seeing you, there is such passion in me. Dreamed of this moment. It's why I've run away from my father. He's a parson. A stern Puritan. I don't want you to be gentle.
So, how was your father?
He was in very good spirits.
Allegory, my honored pupils, is everything. Never forget this. For the finest allegories in Britain, you should look no further than my ceiling in the Painted Hall at Greenwich. The artist works for his patron. Art is therefore for the rich. It is therefore dull, pompous, and fatuous.
Well, you know that's entirely unfair.
Tell me, do you think he'd visit us if we asked him to come and paint our ceiling?
Nathaniel Hirsch. I don't know Mr. Hirsch, but this is an interesting engraving.
Ladies and gentlemen, step forward and take a look.
In peace then, shall I?
Boo.
And Mr. Hogarth.
Fortune has smiled on you.
More swiftly than even I had imagined.
Mother Nita must have been sorry to see you go.
She was handsomely compensated.
And you are still costing him dear, I see, Mr. Nathaniel Hirsch.
I adore him. He fills my life with pleasure and amusement. And I wish to make him a gift of a portrait. I assume from your prompt attendance that you wish to accept this commission. It seemed to me you are a very good artist, Mr. Hogarth. Or am I a very poor judge?
I'm the best artist in England.
Yet such genius has holes in his shoes.
I want to paint you. Will you come to my studio for the portrait?
I'd prefer it if you came here.
Mr. Hirsch might interrupt us.
I wish to be here when he visits.
You're his chattel.
If you consider yourself too grand, sir, I'm sure I can employ a lesser artist and perhaps even save myself some guineas.
Forgive me. It would be an honor.
Is she the girl from the inn?
Yes. No. She's a fine lady now. Don't worry, she's a paying client.
Oh, that's good.
Mm.
What's Mrs. Hogarth like?
She's an angel of God.
Does she know you're all alone with the courtesan? But of course, you don't tell her that.
Surprised to hear you use the word courtesan.
What would you prefer? You think me a harlot? Cyprian? Mole? A votary of Venus? Now, isn't that a pretty phrase?
Does he treat you well, Mr. Hirsch?
You mean, is he gentle in the act? Not particularly. But at least he tends to be quick. If I do my work well, he reaches full satisfaction externally. Forgive me, sir, if I upset you. It's just we whores, we tend to say things that make respectable gentlemen blush. Can't help it.
But an artist. A real artist isn't easily embarrassed. You see, to paint something, to find what it really is and paint that, to look inside your subject, you must stare at them and stare at them. Stare right through the clothes on their back, through their bodices, petticoats, through their skin and bones, to their very soul. Who they really are.
Heavens. What God-fearing church-going Christians would dream of such a thing? Famous. Will you be richer than Mr. Hirsch?
Yes.
Is this how you see me, this uncorrupted little child?
Is that what you see? A child?
No. Actually, no, you're right. There's nothing innocent in this face.
That's not what I meant.
What is it then?
Fear.
It's not fear. It's disappointment. Mr. Hirsch! Look at the charming drawing Mr. Hogarth is making of me.
Mr. Hirsch.
Hogarth. Hogarth.
Yes. Perhaps you've seen my paintings of the Beggar's Opera at the Covent Garden Theatre.
A Beggar's Opera? Whatever next? A Sluts Symphony? Catamite's Concerto? The Thieves' Theatre?
Sir, I'm impressed by how much you have practiced your disgust. But I can assure you I am a respected artist. I studied with Sir James Thornhill, sergeant painter to the court.
And made off with his daughter, I understand. Does Sir James know you are sneaking around Covent Garden, drawing ladies who belong to someone else?
Sir, I am an artist, drawing an interesting subject.
I see. In that case, I trust this is sufficient. Was there something else, Hogarth?
Belong to someone else.
Men kill each other for this. Women leave their children at the roadside preferring oblivion. It's either desperation or the key to inspiration.
It's so pure.
It's the devil, Will. Let's see what he tastes like.
I've been doing drugs for 12 years. Not necessarily heroin, cannabis, speed, acid, mushrooms, everything.
He tastes of rotten potatoes and catgut.
God, yes. Let's have some more.
To inspiration.
Desperation.
Sir James, how marvellous to see you.
And unprecedented, too.
What have you to drink?
Have some gin.
Gin?
We have some wine.
Oh, just give him some gin.
I've been telling my father you've been doing such good work, Will.
Not finished the commission yet, I see.
Oh, she's too damned hideous.
I've been telling him about your new sketches.
Boards and strumpets. Fornication and drunkenness. Is this what you now consider to be art?
Modern tragedy, sir. Piss and shit. And too much gin. That's Mother Needham. Well known in Drury Lane.
Make them think, they make them laugh. What you don't get from a seeming.
I really don't follow you.
You don't follow. The man has a fine house. Servants. Great fortune. His shop burns down in the night. Suddenly he and his family are destitute. But he has a pretty daughter. In desperation, she decides to sell her body for 3-4 guineas. But of course it's not only her body. She has to sell her soul. That's what I'm going to paint. Innocence. On the precipice of damnation.
Why should decent people care what happens to these vermin? How does this enable the human spirit, this glorification of sin? Of course they're doomed. Or do you think that by illustrating their damnation, you can change that?
You're one of the finest draftsmen I ever taught, William. You shouldn't waste your talents on things that nobody's going to care about, or even fewer will pay for. Where did you find this wretched creature?
Oh, she's no one in particular. A whore.
A platonistic whore.
Not half so pretty as I thought.
What do you want to do to me, Mr. Hirsch? Perhaps bruise me a little. Make me even uglier.
You think I'm very stupid, don't you?
I worship you.
A parson's daughter, indeed. There are thousands of whores like you.
No, there aren't.
How many men are you fucking when I'm not here, slut?
Why would I take my pleasure with a toad like William Hogarth when I have you?
Reporters were offered sex with children as young as 9. An investigation into child prostitution suggests that the town is being...
Mr. Hogarth.
Is your mistress at home?
Come on. I never much trusted that bastard.
I should have thrashed him.
I should like to see that. He paid for all this. Stole his pocket watch on the way out. What do you want, Mr. Hogarth? It's about the commission. Can't afford it anymore. What's the need, him? Stoned to death like something from the Bible. She was careless. Too unsubtle.
You, however, only make excellent choices. I saw her arrest with my own eyes. Please be cautious.
Oh, you don't have to worry. I'll find myself another wealthy gentleman. And then you can paint any number of portraits of me. I saw your painting of the Beggar's Opera. Most impressive, Mr. Hogarth. Do you still want to paint me?
More than ever.
And what will you do with your paintings? Hang them up in the theatre? How will elderly gentlemen ogle me at private viewings? Don't I deserve a share?
If your image becomes the talk of London, perhaps you could put your prices up.
Sarah! I may have fallen on hard times. But the gutter hasn't claimed me. And you'll see. I will rise from it.
Right, Mr. Hogarth. Time to go.
Doing us both proud, huh? Has he settled his bill? Because right now I could do it a little satisfying myself.
Rise from it, will you?
Mr. Hogarth.
such her lovely eyes, eh? Lovely blue eyes like little patches of sky. Come on, now I look after you. Come on, we'll get you warm. Come on.
Sir James.
What sort of man forces his wife to borrow from her father?
Father, it was just a small amount, Will, to cover some immediate expenses.
I'll finish the commission. How often do you take his money?
This is the first time, and never before.
Why would you insult me in this way? I owe a living.
There were some creditors, Will, that just simply had to be paid.
Yes,
people are paid.
Where were the creditors,
Jim? The landlord, for instance, he's not a nice man, though, and I've spoken to him so many
times.
One and six. One and five, then, sir. I promise you I'm quite clean. I've got a child to feed, sir.
No.
Bless you, sir.
I'll pay you for an hour. What an hour with you would cost?
5 guineas.
Then you're a virgin, maybe. A shilling and sixpence.
4 guineas.
I need you to be more natural.
You mean take my clothes off?
I mean less like a whore. Just talk.
Why did you marry your wife? You eloped with her. So there must have been such ferocious passion. And now you're bored with her.
She loves me. More than I deserve. What was it like growing up the daughter of a drunken clergyman?
You didn't believe that. Your father must have been proud of his little boy. Did he realize your gift as an artist?
He was penniless. A dreamer. So there was never any prospect of an artist's apprenticeship. I trained as an engraver. And to feed myself, I had to copy other artists' work. A hack. But look at me. An artist for hire. You and I. We're the same.
We're not the same. There have always been millions of girls like me.
You have dignity.
I doubt most men think I've got much dignity.
Well, they're animals. Like that thug who comes to take your money.
He'll be swinging from a rope before he's 30. He's rather handsome, though. Don't you think? He was a highwayman, or so he says. He's quite protective, too. in his own way. He won't rescue me.
I will.
How? Come on. Finish drawing. I need to go and buy some things.
What things?
Food, Will.
Mary. It's not a dream, my future. I will be successful, and I will be rich. You're going to grow old before your time. I want to save you.
When, Will? Grow old before my time. I want a set of rooms, better rooms than these, further west, away from the halls and the taverns. And a child. Just one child would be sufficient.
This is the Don
Bolton.
My father-in-law.
He must hide.
No.
Yes. All right, you miserable sod. Keep the rats in your wig under control.
Come on then, slut.
My name's Mary Collins.
And this morning, under cover of darkness, officers acted on that intelligence. So far, 29 people have been arrested.
Complete. I shall be in a position to repay you by the end of the week.
Oh, if they pay promptly, which clients frequently don't. You're right. This is fine work. A man who paints like this, William, can indeed maintain a wife. Perhaps with a little help from a bad-tempered old man.
Thank you, Sir James. I'm planning a whole series. It's a narrative about the harlot. It begins with her arrival in London.
And here she's a fine lady. Well, a courtesan.
And this, of course, is the moment of climax. The whore meets her fate. Her doom. How splendid. This silly hair looks like Mr. Gonson, the magistrate of Westminster. He should pay you for such a flattering portrait.
Would he fit that well?
What more does a magistrate want than to be shown performing a moral duty? This woman deserves to be condemned to jail. To rot. Where she can do no harm. I shall find more commissions. I'll get you out of here.
Dresses. Darn dresses.
What?
No. Serge jewelry. A starched linen. And a servant.
friend. And servants will.
She'll have an African slave.
A tall one. And loyal. He's got to be loyal. He's no good having a slave. If he comes away, or God murders me in my sleep, and then.
Of course, an obedient slave.
What do you want, Will?
Time's up, unless you've got another 5 shillings.
Let her rest. She needs time to sleep. Is there somewhere where there's less din?
Here.
Memories are of these cells. My mother stroking my brother and I, trying to keep us warm. You see, all my father's dreams of prosperity, all his plans, that brought us to the edge of ruin. He was going to make his fortune with a dictionary.
When once plucked, 'tis no longer a glory to Covent Garden to scent as yet sweet. There fades and shrinks and grows past all enduring.
Look away from me.
Rod stings and dies and is trod under feet.
Staff run from cell to cell, removing plastic bags from heads, ropes and clothes from around prisoners' necks.
All female prisons are having to deal with very, very disturbing women coming into custody, very high levels of self-harm, and inevitably deaths.
She's not here.
Okay.
Young fella came, paid for her release. Rival for her affections, I take it. To be frank, you don't stand a chance.
Come on, you thieving witch.
Wind yourself up.
I'm all right. Hang on. Oh. Mum, I'll come back with the chocolate.
Yeah, this should work, son.
Looking for Mary Collins?
Have a check.
From York?
Yes, yes, another bottle. I'm getting it. Which girl you want?
Mary Collins?
Come back in half an hour.
No, say 20 minutes.
I'll have the money now, though. 2 shillings. That's it. Hey! Get in the fucking room there! Now, someone go and get me a bottle of brandy.
I said.
Four at him. 10. This old bastard's not done in 10. He'll collapse of exhaustion anyway. Be 4 shillings, though.
Stop what I'm here for.
Who are the artists? Get out! And stay out!
Is this what you want?
What's it got to do with you?
I came here to find you.
Well, I don't want to see you. I don't want you coming here, pestering me with your pathetic drawings and your empty promises. Just leave me alone! Just don't forgive this outrageous interruption.
My owner, you see. She's my property.
Crabtree's still owing 8 shillings.
Richard Harper, the night man in Clerkenwell, sent some of his back, so I think we'll have to do them again. And another big order came in yesterday from a wig maker who wants some advertisements for his business, but I...
Mrs. Hogarth. Good day to you. William, Henry's play has flopped disastrously, and he's in need of an evening's oblivion. Please don't force me to listen to his woes alone.
It's just that there's... We've got to do some of those...
Henry will be devastated.
Of course he must go.
I shall finish this later.
Perhaps there are new ways of earning a living.
You're far too concerned with what's new. What's new is merely fashion.
I'm concerned with the truth, which is rarely fashionable.
Oh, that's why the public has avoided your play.
Why am I talking to you?
A man obsessed with naval history who's never set foot on a boat is not likely to understand the truth.
Why am I painting so, Henry? Truthful or not?
You mean you're a whore?
Is that what God intended, do you think?
Not sure it's much to do with God.
Contemptible bastard.
Ooh, God.
William.
What are you doing?
Sorry, I was looking for Mr. Hogarth. It's still warm. They're wonderful, aren't they? My husband has a remarkable ability. It's interesting to meet you. My husband's news.
And you. Your husband always spoke very highly of you.
I'm not sure I like to think of him speaking of me at all.
Well, he did, often. There are things he didn't tell me. I wonder, are these your children? It's funny, I looked at your face for so long, but I've never known your name.
Mary.
Oh, how virginal.
My mother had hopes for me which proved impossible to fulfill.
Why was that? Some unfortunate youthful circumstance.
Weakness of character. Mr. Hogarth has been rather too generous in his paintings, I think. At least, if I was that beautiful once, it's slowly rotting away. To your delight, madam, I'm quite sure.
It's not an affectionate likeness. I seem rather haughty. Or perhaps he's poking fun at me.
Why have you come?
Cold and hungry. And your husband is a generous man,
is he? Well, unfortunately, our own circumstances are not the best they have been.
I see.
Mrs. H.
William, you have a visitor.
I was just about to leave. Mr. Hogarth. There is a matter I need to speak to you of. Some unsettled business.
Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you for bringing my husband home safely.
No business coming here.
She wanted money. Well, I think her life's rather hard.
Since her story is incomplete, you should finish it, Will. Will you finish the paintings? Will you do something with them? I finished them so you can... Well, you can sell them and be done with it.
Mr. Hogarth.
Madam's on her own.
Said you needed money.
You have a son.
Can you even remember all the possible fathers?
I should have told you before. His name's William.
Are you going to seek out every gullible fool who might be persuaded to part with a few pennies? What about your jailer? Or your pimp?
I've missed you.
Well, as long as you're not staying much longer, Mr. Hogarth, this should do.
That money is for her.
I love one waiting. So get rid of him.
See you again. How does her story end?
What do you think?
This is a moral tale. The consequences of sin and depravity should be a happy ending.
And there is no chance of redemption.
Think about when you're drawing.
What?
When you first drew me, what went through your mind?
Oh. I was thinking, who's this young whore from the North Country?
I thought your drawing was charming.
And then I opened my mouth.
You captured something in that drawing. Something that was more than a harlot. And when you spoke to me, I was intrigued. But
Unfortunately, I could tell you were penniless.
Hmm. I told you I was penniless.
And unfortunately, I could tell you were honest. He is yours, Will.
Splendid. It's almost as if he were there. Oh, I love the monkey. And this little fellow in his turban. The rogue, sneaking out at the back. Most charming. I didn't expect them to be so awfully amusing.
It's a while since I used one of these.
I never understood them. After all, who would eat with a glove on his tongue?
Will, I thought we agreed the story was over.
No, sir, it's not over.
A moral tale indeed, to see the sinner punished as she deserves. Mr. Hogarth, I should like very much to acquire the complete set.
They're not finished yet. I don't appreciate your presence here.
No.
When they're finished, when the story's done, I'll tell you.
Is this how you want it to be, William?
Reject our offer of friendship, and you'll have few patrons indeed.
And if you do reject them, William, offers to buy your paintings, what are you going to do then? Go back to etching business cards?
I'm not selling them to him, Jane. I'm not selling the paintings to anyone. I have a better idea. Already. I'm making money. I think I'm going to make a very good deal of money.
You could lend me a few guineas. I have a cut to the pawn shop again.
No.
Whore.
At this rate, people won't need to buy paintings anymore.
So you'll leave her alone forever.
100 guineas.
60.
You had a rich auntie die or something.
If you ever trouble her again, you'll find yourself thrown in Newgate, you understand?
Forever's going to be short. Not a pretty illness, pox. Nasty pink blisters all over the place. Worst in the folds of her skin.
All those wrinkles she's got these days. Where did all those wrinkles come from? And you should see the state of our cunt.
We found examples of how AIDS and poverty are ruining lives. She doesn't want her neighbours to know she's been a prostitute since she was 16. She needs money because her mother is sick with AIDS and too ill to work.
Swelling in your ear, measure of gunpowder will prevent infection of the gun.
What are you getting at?
This is my own special salivation treatment, sir. My cathartic electuary with salts of vipers and 12 other ingredients which I have no intention of divulging. It is the best possible remedy for her condition, sir.
It's mercury. It's poison.
Yes, well, that's why it's necessary for a physician to administer it.
Get out. Parasite.
Get out! It is the best possible remedy for her condition. Remedy for her condition.
Get out!
William to me. Yeah.
Thanks, William.
If he was your child, Will, I could have loved him. I could love any child, Will. He wouldn't have to be ours. You're cursed with a barren wife.
No.
Then God takes your child.
If this is a punishment, it is for my sins, not yours.
Said he carried on painting her. Put all those drawings to good use.
I'll pay for a proper headstone. I'll tell the parish she was our housemaid.
Thank you, Mr. Hogarth. If you paint one more picture, perhaps he could honour her with a wake.
St. James tells me you've had a good many subscriptions. And I'm not surprised, sir. I commend you. There's nothing on earth like a harlot's progress.
Remarkable work. It makes me feel so very old-fashioned. I was very angry with you, William, when you married my daughter. But now I've welcomed you back into my family. I've always known you were talented. But you're always so angry, so rebellious. I'm glad you've matured and softened with age. I think perhaps you're going to become a very great artist.
Thank you, Sir James.
Which will reflect well on me, as long as you don't become too great and overshadow me. The priest there with that look on his face, it's so very amusing.
It's interesting you see that, Sir James. He's not amusing. He's contemptible.
Mm-hmm.
William Hogarth.
Jane and I have no children of our own. And we won't now.
What's his name again?
But this is our legacy. History will say that the artist William Hogarth was a good man. A good man who lived a good life. We'll be right back.